For every product you sell, there are hundreds of possible data points. So it's crucial to have a product database to keep track of all of this. A product database is a centralized collection of all of the information about all of your products. So it has all of the relevant data for the marketing, sales, and the distribution of your products. And it's basically the foundation of your online store. Which is why in today's video, I'm going to walk you through the steps of how to set up a product database in Google Sheets. Using Google Sheets is a good place to start when it comes to managing your product database, but just keep in mind that as your database starts to grow, so do the complexities of managing it, which is why at the end of this video, I'll also introduce you to another more efficient method of building your database. All right, whichever method you choose, the first step will always be the same. To define your data structure. This is the foundation for a solid product database. So take the time to define which data points, also referred to as attributes, you're going to need for your specific products. Start by gathering all of the existing information you have for your products and make sure that all of the necessary information is represented. Then you can delve into your product's unique characteristics, your target audience's preferences, and industry standards to create your list of attributes. For example, some attributes that you might include are SKU or another product identifier, product name, description, materials, dimensions, and price. Now, this is just an example. Remember that the specific attributes you choose will depend on your business, industry, and customer needs. You should also define what format your data should be in. For example, do you need your decimals to come after a comma or after a period? Do you need your currencies in dollars or euros? By doing this, you'll be able to ensure consistency and efficiency throughout your database, which in turn will help you create a database that not only meets your current requirements, but can also adapt to the evolving demands of your business. Now that you have your data structure defined, it's time for the easiest step in the process, setting up a Google Sheets document. Just in case you're not already familiar with Google Sheets, you can access it for free with any Google account. And if you don't have an account, you can also get one for free. Anyway, to create a Google Sheet, just go to Google, click on this grid here, and scroll down until you find the sheet icon. It'll prompt you to log in or create an account. And once you're in, click on Start a New Blank Spreadsheet. Your new Google Sheet document will open and you can start labeling your columns according to the attributes that you defined in step one. Step three, import your data. It's time to start populating your spreadsheet with your product data. This step can be time consuming, especially if you have a vast product catalog, but it's necessary if you want to centralize your product information in one database. Now to do this, you can either add data in manually, you know,
typing it in one by one, cell by cell.
Or if you have your data in separate spreadsheets or documents, you can copy paste or import it directly. For more information on that, you can check out the video that I'm linking in the description that explains how to import and merge your data from multiple spreadsheets into one. Now, this is what your spreadsheet might look like once you've imported the data. Here, we've set up columns for the product name, description, SKU, price, and image URL, and each row represents a product. Now, super important, when you're entering the data for each product in the corresponding rows of your spreadsheet, make sure to stay consistent with your formatting and double and triple check for accuracy. There are some things that can help you with that, which brings us to step four, validation and quality control. As your product database starts to grow, data entry errors can become a serious issue. So our next step is to make sure you implement data validation and quality control processes to maintain your data integrity. To do this, you're going to need to consistently complete three different checks. Number one, check for duplicate entries. Having duplicates in your spreadsheets can cause your products to accidentally appear in your store more than you want, resulting in incorrect inventory, recording, and unhappy customers. You can check for this by using conditional formatting to highlight duplicate SKUs or product names. To do this, select the column that you want to check for duplicates. In this example, we'll select column A. Then up in the toolbar, click Format, followed by Conditional Formatting. A menu on the right-hand side of the screen will appear and you'll see a prompt labeled Format Cells If. Click that and scroll to the bottom until you find Custom Formula Is and click on that. Then you'll want to use a Count If formula to look for duplicates. Since column A is our example, our formula would be what you see on the screen here. This formula tells the sheet where to look for duplicates. The information in the parentheses represents the column that you want to track and the specific cell you want to start with. The information outside the parentheses states that you want the sheet to count duplicates or anything appearing more than once. Another option is to select the column that you want to check. Click Data in the main toolbar, then Data Cleanup and Remove Duplicates. But this removes duplicate data without highlighting it or giving you the ability to check it first. 2, check for missing information. Missing information within your spreadsheets can result in products with incomplete information making it out to your customers. There are 2 ways to check for this. Like we did with duplicate data, you can use conditional formatting to highlight empty cells. To do that, we'll set the rules to format cells if is empty. Alternatively, you can set up a filter for your columns. Highlight the column that you want to check and select the funnel icon in the top navigation bar. Now that the filter is applied, click on the filter icon that's located next to the column that you selected. Click Clear and select Blanks and OK. Your sheet will now show you any blanks or missing information from your selected area. Personally, I prefer this method because it hides the rows that have completed information and only shows you the ones with missing products, which is great when you have a lot of products. 3, check for consistent formatting. You'll also need to ensure that all of your data is formatted consistently. For example, making sure that you're using the same currency format for prices. You can do this by selecting the column you wish to adjust and using the automatic format options such as currency, percentage, or decimal. From here, you'll need to regularly review and clean your data to avoid issues in the future. We also have a video coming up with more data validation tips, so make sure that you subscribe and turn on those notifications so that you don't miss it. Step 5, categorization and taxonomy. The next step to complete is categorizing your products. You can create categories or hierarchies to group similar products together, which is essential for both organization and improving customer experience. Now, you might have done this in step 3, but I'd like to emphasize it as its own step because, especially when you're bringing in data from multiple sheets, this might need some cleanup. In Google Sheets, you can create a separate column for category and enter the appropriate path for each of your products. For example, if you run an e-commerce store that offers a range of outdoor equipment, you could consider the following categorization. Outdoors and sports would be your main category, and camping gear and hiking equipment would be your subcategories, followed by more niche product categories like tents, sleeping bags, hiking boots, and backpacks. This step is critical for improving navigation and helping customers easily find what they're looking for, and it'll also help you find information in your database faster. Step 6, enrich your product information. Having complete and rich product data will provide a better shopping experience for your customers, leading to higher conversions. This means that including images, videos, and more detailed specifications can directly affect the success of your sales. Enriching your product data enhances the shopping experience and provides customers with more information to make a more informed and more frequent purchasing decisions. With Google Sheets, you can include links to product images or videos directly in your spreadsheet. And for detailed specifications, you can create additional columns to provide more information. Now, the only downside to this is that if you add these digital assets as links, you'll need to open them in separate tabs, so you won't actually get a visual glimpse of your product. And if you do include an actual image as opposed to the link, it could expand your row size, which means more scrolling. But don't worry, at the end of this video, I'll show you how to get around this because at the end of the day, it's important to keep all of your data together. I mean, that's what a database is for, right? Okay, you've now officially set up a product database in Google Sheets. This is an excellent starting point, especially for businesses with smaller product catalogs. However, as your business expands, managing product data in spreadsheets can become challenging, time-consuming, and error-prone. This brings us to what I mentioned at the beginning of this video, a more efficient method of building your product information database, which is by using product information management software, or PIM. PIM software stands out as an advanced alternative for spreadsheets, and it's specifically designed with data and e-commerce businesses in mind. With PIM software, you can store and manage all of your product assets from one place, make fast and easy bulk edits to thousands of products at once, and use integrated features to check for complete and consistent data. If you want to learn more about what this tool can do, you can check out the resources that I left in the description, which explain all about this tool. And the best part is a lot of them have freemium versions, so you can get started for free and expand to more advanced features as your business grows. Anyway, I hope this video helped you to build a product database for your e-commerce business. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments below. And don't forget to subscribe for more videos and tips about e-commerce and data management. Our formula is going to be this one.